All praise is due to Allah. I ask Allah Ta'ala to raise the rank of Prophet Muhammad and his good al and companions, and to protect his nation from that which he fears for it. Furthermore, I advise you as I advise myself to fear Allah, fulfill the obligations, and refrain from committing sins. Ayah 36 of Surah An-Nisa means, worship Allah and do not associate any partners with Him. Be a fair companion to your parents and be kind to them. Be kind to your relatives, the orphans, the poor, your close and far neighbors, whether related to you or not, your friend in proximity and companion in travel, and to those who you possess and animals. Surely Allah does not accept those who are arrogant and conceited. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, in this glorious ayah, Allah the Exalted ordered us to worship Him alone and to not associate any partners with Him. And in this glorious ayah, Allah ordered us to present to our parents and kin kindness and good conduct, to show courtesy to the orphans, to support the needy and the poor, to the traveler who is stranded. Also, in this ayah, there is an urge to treat one's neighbors kindly without bias. Ayah 36 of Surah An-Nisa means, your close and far neighbors, whether related or not. The Prophet urged to treat the neighbor kindly by saying, let the one who believes in Allah and the Day of Judgment treat his neighbor with acts of kindness. So treat your neighbor with acts of kindness, and ask your wives to do the same with their female neighbors. In this regard, the Prophet, peace be upon him, said what means, O Muslim woman, do not treat your female neighbors in malice, not even in the slightest manner. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said what means, the best neighbor is the one who treats his neighbors kindly. The rights that apply to neighbors apply to everyone who lives in a radius near to your home. However, priority is given to those who live closer to your house than those further in proximity, and so on. Abu Dharr al-Ghifari, may Allah raise his rank, said, my beloved Prophet, peace be upon him, advised me by saying, if you were to cook soup, increase its water content and offer a portion to some of your neighbors. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, I ask you to fear Allah by being considerate to the rights of your neighbors. Avoid saying or doing what might harm them. Don't ask about what does not concern you. Don't try to seek and keep track of their defects. Don't pry into what they don't want you to see. And don't overhear what they don't want you to listen. Visit your neighbor if he becomes sick. Treat him the way you would like to be treated. Lower your gaze when you see the woman of your neighborhood. Join your neighbor for meals and drinks. Be patient with him if he were to harm you. Ask yourself the following questions and think. How many people nowadays harm their neighbors? How much conflict actually occurs between neighbors because one fails to follow the manners the Prophet, peace be upon him, advised us to display, especially with one's neighbors. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said what means, Angel Jibreel kept drawing my attention to treating the neighbor in a good way to a point that I thought he would tell me that the neighbor is entitled to inherit his neighbor. Finally, I ask Allah to make you and I amongst those who treat our neighbors in a good way. And Allah knows best.